Hello, everyone, and welcome to JQT Hanukkah Hotties. My name is Carmel Tanaka, and I'm the founder and executive director of JQT Vancouver, a Jewish queer and trans nonprofit dedicated to queering Jewish space and Jew-ifying queer space in Vancouver, BC, on the ancestral and unceded territories of the Musqueam, Squamish, and Tsleil-Waututh peoples. If you do not know the land on which you live, work, and play, check out native-land.ca. For Hanukkah this year, we are being generously supported by Creating Accessible Neighborhoods, an organization that advocates for and educates about disabled people with intersecting identities. You can learn more about this fantastic organization doing amazing work at canbc.org. For each candle of the holiday, we have a Hanukkah Hottie or more joining us to light their Hanukkah or perhaps share another tradition and chit-chat about the wonderful things they do in life for the duration of the candles burning. Now, for our sixth candle of Hanukkah Hotties, we are joined by the Klezbians, a band of unruly chutzpah-licious musicians from the Isle of Klezbos in Victoria, British Columbia. I had the honor of interviewing a whole bunch of them for the BC Jewish Queer and Trans Oral History Project. There's a link in the chat. Tuning in from Victoria, BC on Vancouver Island, let's welcome the Klezbians. Hello! Make some noise! Hi! It is such an honor to have you here, and I feel so lucky that I get to see you physically twice in 1 week. This is so great, and I'm so glad that all of you could make it today. In order to start, why don't we get some heat happening here? Who would like to come and light the Hanukkiahs?
We have a whole selection of candles and Hanukkiahs here today. And we have our Shabbat candles as well. So
I'll be joining the age-old question. Is it the Hanukkah candles or is it the Shabbos candles first?
You can light them. Almost.
All right. Asher yishanu mitzvotah v'sivanu lahadlik ner shel Hanukkah. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam she'asa nisim avoteinu bayamim Ha'em ba'zman ha'zeh.
And Shabbat candles. Shabbat candles. Yes.
Ratanai Eloheinu melech haolam.
This
is Amen. That is so lovely. I love all of your Hanukkiah. I also have a bunch of light happening here. Thank you for lighting the candles. Why don't you introduce the lovely candle lighters? Who do we have?
I'm the lovely Debbie, and this was actually a wedding present to me in 1965.
Oh, wow.
Which coincidentally was the year that I was born.
But I'm not her daughter. So. and I'm Levi, or Lauren, or Rabbi. Or Rabbi, I guess, sometimes. Rabbi Levi. And this is my Hanukkiah, and I don't know where I got it. To be honest with you, I can't remember.
And I'm the Shabbos candles.
This is my Hanukkiah that comes from, I think it was bought in Israel. I think it was given to me by my parents when some attempt to make me that I might go to Israel someday.
Yes.
It's been around a long time.
And our smallest candle lighter is now hiding.
Okay, fair enough.
She just been found out, so now she's really
She's waving from the corner.
Wonderful. Well, thank you, Susan. I was talking while you were also talking, so I don't know if everyone caught your name. But yeah, I look forward to hearing some music and hearing from the rest of the band who's here.
Yes. All right.
Woo-hoo! What do you say? Let's
okay.
do this.
How about some music now?
Yeah, some music would be great.
Okay, I just need some.
Maybe.
This is the one you know with you.
Yeah.
So maybe you can talk while we're getting
sure. Our... Well, this lovely band had the honor of going on stage at the Hanukkah market at the local JCC and brought all of their amazingness. And I got to hear it and I videotaped it for all of the people tuning in on Facebook Live. So that was also fun. Yep. I'm sorry the power went out a bunch of times while you were playing, but nothing stopped you from getting the crowd going and dancing and having a good time. So that's wonderful.
Yeah. Rain, power outages, we can do it.
Okay. All
right. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Give it a note first.
Called the peanut because somebody who used to be in our band wrote it for us, so I don't know anything about that.
But the third song that's a mashup is Mazel Tov. And if people want to look into klezmer music and they go on Google and they look up Mazel Tov, they'll find some fabulous musicians who do that song. It's like kind of a klezmer classic.
Well, it's fantastic. It looks like you were having a fantastic time too. Much fun. I really wanted to be there in person.
Yeah, it's our go-to. Like, it's our warm-up song.
We love klezmer because all these instruments are what we used to play in elementary school.
Yeah.
These are old. And then we reacquainted ourselves in our 50s with them. And so there's really only 8 notes in klezmer. So we're really, it's good.
And the thing I love the most about klezmer is it's happy music in minor keys.
Yeah.
I think that's so Jewish.
No, maybe.
So Jewish, the minor keys for sure. Oh, that's great.
It is, a bar mitzvah polka, that's absolutely true.
Yeah. Okay, so a little Hanukkah, should we play a little
silly
song?
Yeah. Ooh, I like the sounds of that.
Fasten your seatbelts.
What is the story on this? So Sibby Bond is a dreidel. For those of you if you tuned into Hanukkah Hotties, you're already probably pretty Sibby Boned out by the sixth night. But so it's just telling the Sibby Bond to spin. So maybe somebody up here might spin a little bit.
I think I can do that.
You like a dreidel?
By the way, we were going to do this topless, but then told us not to. But other than that,
wonderful. Oh, you're having way too much fun without me.
We need you. Totally.
You know, I could also go topless. I could be like a side axe on the side. I don't know. That would probably go against Facebook rules, but this is great. What else? I know you have another song.
Yeah, we
can talk. We can talk some more. I want to hear how the Klezmians all got started. Is there someone who wants to come up here and share?
I'll do that. I think we've been together about 10 years, and it all started. My partner, when she turned 40, decided to learn the accordion. So she used to bring her accordion to our lesbian seders and play Dayenu. And then this Sue and Susan both wanted to play with her. So it got a little bit more, you know.
Wait a minute, no. Donna and I played together. She taught me. We were the only goys in the whole, with our own goy band. And then
girl boy band.
And then one time, because I only practiced the accordion one time a year in order for the Seder. And then one time you said, that seems, if you could do it, I could do it probably.
I think I said that. I think I was a little drunk.
So I gave her my accordion because I never ever played it. And I said, why don't you just try it? And she came back better than me, and it pissed me right off.
Oh no, replaced.
But I in that accordion to Susan, and then the band started really from there.
But basically, if you put Sue in a room with a bunch of instruments and lock her in, 20 minutes later, she can play them all.
Only because there's only 8 notes.
So anyway, the 3 of them played. And then Lauren and Michelle moved to town with their clarinets. And
we needed a spot. There was a waiting list to get into the Seder. So we had to be creative and figure out, so how are we going to get in? We're like, so we start, play the clarinets. Yeah. Let's start.
Ah!
Let's
be
in it, and then we'll be able to come to the Seder.
Yeah.
And it worked. And isn't it true that you guys didn't even know you played clarinets in high school? Like, you guys
we
married.
Didn't know
so
that
way you've been married.
No, we did know when we first met.
Oh,
we did. So we both played clarinet in high school. And when we met, like, a odd zillion years ago, it was one of those things that after, like, about 4 or 5 dates we were talking about. We actually both played really rare, like, bass version clarinets in band.
Oh, weird.
Like, there's only one person. It's usually not a girl. Who plays the giant silver thing that looks like plumbing.
Oh,
with the stick?
We both played that.
Wow.
It was really
romantic.
It was very romantic.
I hear the plumbing instruments
and romantic. And then Cass with the sax we picked up next.
Yeah.
Well, make the connection though, then it comes back to Donna's
memorial.
Yeah. My partner got very sick and died at the end of 2013. And we had a big, I sat shiva for a week, and then we had a big party, basically.
And I think that's when our band really formed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We played for Donna's celebration.
It was the first time we practiced, because
yeah.
it meant something to
yeah.
us, and we
yeah.
practiced for
yeah.
months.
And Kath was in the audience, she's like, if those women can play, I can totally finally pick up the instrument I've always wanted to pick up.
Yeah, so I said to Sue, I love it. I thought if I knew how to play the sax, I'd come and play with you. And she said, take a couple of lessons and join us.
Yeah.
So I did. So for years, these 4 people had to deal with me learning this.
But now she's the only one that actually takes lessons and the only one that actually practices.
Yeah.
And Debbie, can you come a little bit more into the, yeah, perfect.
I've played guitar since I was 10. My mother taught me. But I would still be playing Michael Row the Boat Ashore, if you let me, or Kumbaya, you know. So I sort of joined reluctantly. I thought of myself as Donna's groupie for a long time, but then I'm part of it. And the other guitarist, River, couldn't make it tonight. She's a really good guitarist. I just kind of bang and I jump around.
He jumps.
That's my contribution. You know, jumping.
Physical match. But then these guys go traveling for a long time. I don't know how long you went traveling for. A long time.
8 months.
8 months. And we needed a clarinetist. So we found this one in a ditch somewhere.
In an alleyway.
How did I find you? Cat sat behind me in a community band and the flute sat in front of me. And Kath and the flutist, Julie, knew each other. So they were discussing, we need a clarinetist. So Julie said, talk to Lisa. And that's what Kath did. And that's really how I met
but
Kath.
But not just a clarinet. She needs to be a Jew and a dyke and a clarinetist.
That's
right. And she was right in the middle. She's like, I qualify.
Like right over here, right here.
It's a kind of a criteria.
And then these guys came back and were like, well, you can't leave now. And then to have 3 clarinets.
And I was trying to leave.
What a nightmare. That means I get to dance instead of playing.
Yeah.
Oh, what a riot. You were also amazing. When I had the chance to interview some of you for the Oral History Project, I heard about these epic Pesach Seders for Passover. And I was sharing with you earlier that it is the hottest ticket in town in Victoria. And there's only 25 seats from what I remember. So to get in and you have to have an instrument, would you accept me if I brought my fiddle?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Do you play it?
Of course, I do. I'm not lying to you.
Get her in. All right, we'll talk later.
We'll talk later. All right, business later.
Yeah.
Oh, no, you can't play together on Zoom like this. No, it's impossible.
Oh, wow.
Well, we will play it together.
Okay, so
we will. I'll bring my fiddle.
We're going to play by mirror for you.
Because by mirror, best you shade.
Yes, baby.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Well,
here it is.
Here we go.
Does this thing work?
It does.
Where's my?
Are you going to be using the picture?
Yeah. What's the things that make noise? You know, the little sticky things.
Oh, you don't have these things.
I do. They were here. Keep bantering while I look
for
them.
The brushes.
No,
I actually think that it may be. What about these?
Those are too big. These are too loud. Where's my little guy?
We're doing stage time.
Oh, Jen's got it. Sorry. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, wait. So can I just say one thing before we play this? So at the memorial that we were talking about, there's a whole thing, and there's a video of it, and I was watching the video the other night. Don't ask me why. And I was watching the video, and there's this whole thing where Sue and Jenny are running around up and down, off across the stage, all over the place, because you couldn't find the drumsticks.
Oh.
So, this was 11 years ago. So I'm saying nothing's
continue to be a new and
something
to never
get up. If you want
to. Is that the one? Yeah. Well, now, of all the girls I've known,
and she's known some.
Until I first met you,
she was lonesome.
And when you came inside, dear, my heart grew light, and this old world seemed new to me. Well, you're really swell, I have to admit you deserve expressions that really fit you. And so I racked my brain, hoping to explain all these things that you do to me.
Absolutely incredible.
All right.
You're so much fun. Oh, I was texting our volunteer who's actually a board member as well of JQT, and we're all like, oh my god, they're so cute. So much dyke energy in one room. Yes, amazing.
Available. Right here. Available. Right
here. Ah! Starting a match make service. Well, you know, actually for Hanukkah Hotties last year, we brought on two matchmakers. So if you are interested, we could sign you up.
Are they watching tonight?
I mean, I can connect you. It is, you know, there's a few Jewish queer matchmakers out there, both in Canada and in the US, because it is a demographic of people that are looking to date and find love. So, you know, just saying.
Bring it on.
Sure, I would love to hear one more.
Okay, all right. Unless you want to ask more questions.
I mean, I can talk to you all day long, but you're already in fine form and position. So why don't we hear another one, and then I can bring you up to conclude.
Okay. All right. So this song is usually we do this sort of towards the beginning of our set because it is a welcome and almost a blessing. Rabbeinu Shalom Aleichem means that we bring peace unto you. So Shalom Aleichem, Salam Aleikum. We know that phrase, and it's always precious, and I always say it a little bit like a wish. So that's our wish for everybody. So let's do it.
Very nice. Very nice.
All right.
Only do it.
All right.
Down and come a little bit closer to the candlelight. We want to see all of your faces.
Okay.
And
you are the best audience ever.
You know what? You do have an audience tuning in right now. There's someone who's asking if you need a bass player. You know, I think there's room to grow the band for sure. Great. Is that everyone? I don't want anyone to be hidden behind. Come, everybody.
Everybody, get there. We see
it. This is a good profile picture right here. This is the one.
Get
oh, Screen
capture.
Jenny, I will screen capture later on and I'll send it to you.
So there's so much heat from these candles. I have to tell you, it's actually like a fire.
That and the hot flashes for menopause is a bit much.
Something to look forward to. Well, these lovely human beings, the Klezbians, are also, from what I am told, the in-house band at Congregation Emmanuel. Can you tell us, how did that all get started?
Yeah, it's kind of a joke, actually.
It is kind of a joke.
Yeah,
Rabbi Harry's in-house band.
But Rabbi Harry is just the most, he's just a mensch. We love him. And somehow
he loves us.
He loves us. We did a fundraiser before. They have a social action committee, and we did this beautiful fundraiser for that.
Mm-hmm. But also they do Pride Parade, and
they invite us to be in part of their Pride Parade thing in a couple of years.
It's not easy. What was the fundraiser?
Sorry?
What was the fundraiser?
Oh, it was for their social action group. It's called Avodah. And so basically the social action group of the synagogue. And so we raised like a chunk of money, like we raised a few thousand dollars for them. And they basically
social justice work.
They basically do work in the community, helping vulnerable people in a variety of ways. So,
amazing.
Yeah, and we also did like 1 year we did at our place, which is kind of a transitional and homeless outreach place. They every year, they used to pre-COVID do a latke, like a Hanukkah latke lunch thing. And so we played it that one time. That was super
fun.
Really
fun.
Yeah.
And tasty.
Yeah.
You really weren't. That's true.
Yeah.
What else? I was also at our place, and I remember scooping ice cream for the birthdays for the group. And it was with the Avodah Social Action. So I used to live in Victoria, for those who don't know, me tuning in here. And also, I believe you did Fiddler on the Roof. Is that right? No, not you guys?
No, we
okay,
will.
So before.
Should we?
You really should. Well, I did Fiddler on the Roof at Congregation Emmanuel to raise money to support the Syrian refugee family that they supported. So, if you go back in history, you might see a video or two of somebody dancing and playing the fiddle.
So, were you fiddling?
You have to bring your fiddle over when you come for Pesach.
Yeah, I will definitely bring my fiddle and play with you.
So oh my God.
Really nice. It's a shame.
Well, thank you so much for being amazing. You're all such an inspiration. Your stories are incredible. They at least four of them can be viewed on the Oral History Project on JQT's website. And for everyone else who's joining in, not only a Chag Hanukkah Sameach, but also a Shabbat Shalom. Before we say goodbye, is there anything that you wanted to add?
I just want to thank you for everything you're doing. You're doing a great job. And you bring such a good spirit.
Thank you. Stop. You're so lovely. I love all of you.
Very gifted.
Oh, thank you. Well, I thank the world of you, and thank you all for your support. I love having cheerleaders in Victoria, and I can't wait to visit all of you. So next year in Victoria, as they say.
Absolutely. And thank you for building an incredible community. This is really amazing.
Yeah.
What you're doing.
Truly, I love
that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, stop.
When people all get together under a tent and hang out.
And we'll be talking.
Oh, wait.
We just
go
back and forth on the ferry.
Yeah, exactly. Love
it. Well, many thanks to the Klezbians for joining JQT today as our sixth Hanukkah Hotties. You can follow them on their socials. They just got a social media handle at Klezbians. Woo!
It's at Klezbians.
Is it?
Yeah.
It sure is, and we're tagging you.
What it means is that you can type in at Klezbians on Google, and it'll take you right to our page.
You can actually
say to your Alexa smart speaker, Alexa at Klezbians, and I bet it would. I bet she would say, "I just found a bizarre band."
I love you all. Thank you to our sponsor organization, Creating Accessible Neighborhoods. You can also follow J-cutie on our social media. Links are all in the chat. And thank you for tuning in. Happy Hanukkah, Chag Sameach, and Shabbat Shalom. Bye!
Bye.
Bye. Bye.